إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث العظيم: إن المؤمن ليدرك بحسن خلقه درجة الصائم القائم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a believer will attain by his good behavior, by his good behavior, the rank of one who prays during the night and observes fasting during the day. This is the level of being a good Muslim, good behaving Muslim. The importance of the akhlaq in Islam, the importance of your behavior, your attitude toward the Muslims, the non-Muslims, the animals, everyone. You will reach to the level of the one who is praying at night, fasting during the day. Subhanallah. Because of what? Husnul khuluq. One of the points of husnul khuluq, of course, when we speak about husnul khuluq, there are many things to speak about: the truthfulness, of generosity. There are many things. One of the important points of husnul khuluq, as-satr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Allah, the mighty and sublime, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is forbearing, modest and concealing. Inna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Halimun, Hayyun, Sittir. Some of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to follow these attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to apply these attributes. Like al-hilm, forbearance, and also modest. To be modest. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in this hadith, Inna Allah Hayyun, Halimun, Hayyun, Sittir. Or satir, subhanahu wa ta'ala, yuhib al-satr, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he loves modesty and concealment. Not to expose and disclose the mistakes of the people. Do you like that people speak about your mistakes? Of course not. Of course not. For the normal person. So Allah like that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is covering, concealing our sins. How many sins do we have? We have a lot of sins. And one of the major sins, if you speak about your sin, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concealed, Allah hide your sin. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this hadith, Wallah, very scary hadith, all the sins of my followers will be forgiven. كل أمتي معافى. الحمد لله, there is a big chance that Allah forgives our sins. إلا المجاهرين. إلا المجاهرين. Then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, except those of the مجاهرين. What does it mean, مجاهرين? Those who commit a sin openly or disclose their sins to the people. If the person is a believing person, he has iman, he has faith, okay, no, there is a point of weakness. I do a sin when I am in the point of weakness. But I will not do the sin openly. I will stay alone at home. I will travel to a far place. I don't want people to see me. Of course, Allah sees me. But the problem when the person is doing the sin openly, he wants everyone to see him. Especially nowadays with the social media. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, all the sins of my followers will be forgiven except those of the mujahideen. Then he gave an example, alayhi salatu wasalam. Wa inna min al-majana, aw al-mujahara, an example of such disclosure is that a person commits a sin at night, and though Allah screens it from the public, then he comes in the morning and says, oh so and so, I did such and such evil deed yesterday. Subhanallah, Allah covered your sin. No one knows about your sin except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At night, people when are sleeping. In the morning, the first thing you start with your social media, with your friends, telling them what the mistake that you did yesterday. A'udhu billah. May Allah protect us. Subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, at the end of the hadith, this important hadith, though he spent his night screened by his Lord, and in the morning he removes Allah's screen from himself. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Some people don't want that forgiveness. You try to help them, Allah wants to help them, but they don't want the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah covered your sin. He wakes up in the morning, the first thing to do, to tell everyone about his sin, wal-iyadu billah. One of the hadith, the importance of, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with the believers with this khuluq, as-satir subhanahu wa ta'ala, covering our sins. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a believer will be brought close to his Rabb subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of resurrection and enveloping him in his mercy. He subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him confess his sins by saying, do you remember doing this sin and this sin? He will reply, my Rabb, I remember. Of course, you cannot deny. In front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can you deny? You cannot deny. Now in this dunya, yes. No, I did not do this. It was not a mistake. It was not my mistake. You deny in the dunya. You escape from the police. You escape from your parents, from your husband, wife. You put a lawyer to lie and you do many things in this world. But in the akhirah, before your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you deny, if you lie, your mouth will be closed. Then your limbs will speak. Your body will be a witness, not with you, against you. Subhanallah, my body, yes. I'm defending my body in this dunya, but in the akhirah, your body will be with the haq, with the truth. So this person, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-mu'min, the believer, the believing person. This is the importance of faith, brothers, sisters. The believer will say, I remember. He cannot deny, and he knows, if I deny, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make my body to speak, my skin will speak, my legs, my limbs. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, I covered it up for you in the life of old, and I forgive it for you today. Allahu Akbar. So what is the importance to conceal, to hide my sins? I'm saving this for the day of judgment, because Allah will cover my sins at the day of judgment. Fi yawm al-qiyamah. Then the record of his good deeds will be handed to him. And what about the book of the bad deeds, the sins? Khalas. Forgiven by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The importance of this khuluq, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course, if you want this situation at the Day of Judgment that Allah conceals your sins. What to do? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من سترى مسلما ستره الله يوم فستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever covers the sin of a Muslim, Allah will cover him in this world and in the hereafter. You saw your friend or your brother, your sister doing a sin. You are doing this sin? Immediately I will take a photo to spread what he's doing. A'udhu billah. Astaghfirullah. You should give him an advice. You cover his sin. If you cover his sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you, will cover your sin. Not only in this dunya. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, في الدنيا والآخرة. ستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. Allah will cover your sin in this life and also in the hereafter. أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا معشر من آمن بلسانه, يا معشر من آمن بلسانه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم started this hadith with, O community of people who believe by their tongue, ولم يدخل الإيمان قلبه, سبحان الله, who believe by their tongue and belief did not enter their hearts. They are not real believers. Be careful. لا تغتاب المسلمين. He صلى الله عليه وسلم said, don't backbite Muslims. And don't search for their faults. Don't search. You go to the media, social media, and you try to check what he said before 5 years, before 10 years. And you check with your friends what he said and he did. Don't search for their faults. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ عَوْرَاتِهِمْ. Why? Why he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't follow, don't search for their faults. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for if anyone searches for their faults, Allah will search for his fault. Allahu Akbar. When you try, there is a chance you find faults and there is a chance you don't find anything. But if Allah is searching for your faults, definitely Allah knows all of our faults, all of our mistakes and sins, major, minor, everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will search for his fault. And if Allah searches for the fault of anyone, he disgraces him in his house. Subhanallah. Whatever you do, whatever you do to hide yourself, to conceal your mistakes, Allah can disclose your mistakes. Why? Because you have a bad intention and action. You are trying to do that with the Muslims. The danger of that, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةَ. In Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةَ. They love that the mistakes, to the fahisha, the immorality, to spread. They are not spreading the fahisha, but they are happy when they see in the news, they read in the media, this lady and that brother, this is his mistake and that mistake, they are happy. Subhanallah. This is the sin or the punishment of the person who loves. What about the one who's doing that? Who's spreading that? And what about the person who's doing that? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةِ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. They love that the fahisha, the morality, to spread among the Muslims, the believers. They have a torment in this dunya and the akhirah. Subhanallah. He is very happy, he is not doing anything. Sitting at home. Or with his friends praying, mashallah, giving zakah. But when he watching the media, any mistake, any fault about any Muslim brother, any Muslim sister, he is happy. Subhanallah. For those who are happy, this is wallahi a big problem, brothers, sisters. Those who are happy that the morality is in the community, among the Muslims, they have a severe torment. So no doubt, the torment, the punishment will be more for those who are spreading. May Allah protect us. Allahumma ghafir lil-mu'minin wal-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat al-ahya'i minhum wal-ammat innaka sami'un qaribun mujibud da'wat ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma aminna fi awtanina. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نغتال من فوقنا أو عن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا أو من تحتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا من الأوبئة والأمراض يا رب العالمين. احفظ الشباب والبنات والجميع وجميع المسلمين يا رب العالمين. وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى واشف المرضى منهم يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.